Hi, this is Dr. Bertalan Meshko, the medical futurist, and in this episode I want to address the coronavirus outbreak and how five digital health technologies can help us navigate and overcome COVID-19 and future epidemics like it. Even those of us who remember the SARS, MERS and Ebola outbreaks of recent years feel that this new coronavirus is a little different. While the death rate is fortunately lower, the virus spreads much faster than other viruses of recent times. To fight epidemics like this, our response time needs to fasten up as well, and we have to use all the tools at our disposal. AI to detect the spread of epidemics. On January the 6th, the American CDC issued a notification about a flu-like outbreak in China. They were followed by the WHO on the 9th of January. And since then, that virus became known as the coronavirus or COVID-19, and the outbreak became a global phenomenon. But what not many know is that a Canadian health monitoring AI platform called BlueDot beat both of them to the punch, as it issued a warning on December 31st, a full week before the world caught on. It's obvious that if technologies like this would have played a major role in our prevention strategies, things might have gone differently. Because we've all seen recently that even a week can make the difference between a locally isolated virus and a global pandemic. And BlueDot didn't just foresee the Wuhan outbreak, it correctly predicted its spread too. How did it do it? By going through tons of foreign language news and reports, by tracking animal and plant disease networks, and by accessing global airline ticketing data to predict where and when infected residents are headed next. In this case, BlueDot correctly predicted that the coronavirus would spread from Wuhan to Bangkok, Seoul, and Tokyo in the days following its first appearance. Maybe next time we will rely more on a digital health technology like that. Now let's take a look at what other tools we have to fight the coronavirus and to prevent future pandemics. Interactive maps for monitoring. We have not experienced an outbreak like this in recent times, simply due to the coverage it can get. We are watching it spread with almost real-time data available to anyone. It's like the first Iraq war, when the world was able to watch almost real-time footage for the first time from the comfort of their home. It's also an infodemic. But following an epidemic this closely and this accurately is also crucial to stopping it. Developers at the Johns Hopkins University already created an online dashboard for the coronavirus to visualize and track the reported cases on a daily timescale. They also made the complete set of data downloadable as a Google Sheet. The map shows new cases, confirmed deaths, and recoveries. They collect from various sources, from the WHO and CDC to local Chinese websites and reports, providing more current regional case estimates than the national organizations are capable of. And the best thing about these interactive maps? They are public and transparent. Unlike a lot of governments that try to save face during times when a virus could be confined and isolated. New tech for faster detection. As we mentioned in the introduction, technology has dramatically evolved since the days of the SARS virus. For the current coronavirus outbreak, the culprit was identified within a week from the public announcement, and the first diagnostic test was developed shortly after that. Back during the days of the SARS outbreak, it took days to sequence a virus. These days, it only takes hours. Thanks to technological progress, scientists don't need to cultivate a sufficient number of viruses before examining them anymore. Even small amounts of viral DNA can be detected directly from a patient's spit or blood sample. A Singapore-based company, Veredus Laboratories, has already launched a portable detection kit for labs and hospitals for clinical diagnosis. With faster and portable detection solutions, identifying infected individuals for proper medical care will be quicker, especially when hospitals are overcrowded or the patients live in rural areas. Genome sequencing to find vaccines. On this channel, we talk a lot about the importance of genome sequencing, but it's just as crucial for fighting pandemics than it is for our own health. The genome of the virus was completely sequenced by Chinese scientists in less than a month since the first case had been detected. And as soon as that sequence was public, biotech companies started creating synthetic copies of the virus that could be used in research. Genetic synthesis is also much faster and cheaper than it was 2 decades ago. Then it cost $10 to create a synthetic copy of one single nucleotide, now it's under 10 cents. And this all happened faster than ever before. In comparison, during the SARS virus outbreak, the world had to wait months before the virus got sequenced. And as we will be able to sequence pathogens' genome quicker with evolving technology, the rate of finding adequate therapies will also speed up and help save more lives in the process. Robots to the rescue. As it has been determined that COVID-19 can spread from human to human, medical staff are at high risk of being infected. But medical robots are impervious to cross-infections. This can be real game changers in cases of viral outbreaks. We've seen one case in the US already where a man diagnosed with the coronavirus was being treated by a robot. The robot allows physicians to communicate with the patient through a screen, and it's also equipped with a stethoscope, helping doctors take the man's vitals while minimizing exposure to the staff. Of course, it won't be possible in a jam-packed hospital in China with hundreds of such patients, but with time, quarantined patients could be better monitored with the help of robots. Going further, drones for medical deliveries could also be deployed in similar settings so as to reach quarantine zones like Wuhan and the parts of northern Italy. They can safely take medicines and supplies to the people in need. In the future, once we seamlessly implement all these technologies, we will be able to manage outbreaks like these more adequately. We will have apps to tell us about impending outbreaks and what flight routes we should avoid. Health officials will be able to get to the first patient quickly, track the virus spread more accurately, and isolate and stop the pandemic at its roots. But if the things do get out of control, we'll still have the help of digital technologies for the containment and eventual treatment of outbreaks like the one we witnessed today. But for all that, we need countries like China, not just to impress the world by building a hospital in a single week, but to implement all these advanced technologies at hand as well. Until then, please wash your hands many times a day, don't touch your face, cough into your inner elbow, and stay calm.